Welcome to part 8 of my playthrough of the Division beta. If you've been watching, you know I'm ready to head out and do some more missions or encounters, these last two encounters, and then we'll be on for the big mission. So let's get on with it, eh? Seeing as this is my 8th part, I think I've been doing around 45 minutes of gameplay. I know a lot of it's been free roaming, or as I say, getting sidetracked. But there's quite a lot of stuff to do in this beta, and you know, not to mention the Dark Zone. The multiplayer aspect. This is just single player. But I do plan on hopefully joining someone's game and getting some co-op on the go. In the Dark Zone, as that's pretty hard on your own to get items and get them extracted without other players bloody killing you and taking the stuff you've got. But I did alright in the alpha when I tried it. But for now, we'll just stick to the single player missions aspect of the beta.
Morning. Marked hostile headquarters detected.
Okay, here we go. This is a good one. Let's test the old ACOG scope that I recently just put on this weapon.
See? Nothing. Now get back to your post.
Try for a headshot kill. There you go, two headshots, two kills. Whoa! Stood no chance, mate. Where's this other guy? Don't know if that was smoke or tear gas, but... I don't know what it was. I didn't really want to find out, to be honest.
You crossed a line.
You want me to assault your stronghold? I'm fucking assaulting it, alright. This is suppressing fire.
Informed.
Are you telling me that was a hostile headquarters? I thought that was just some ragtag fuckaroonies. Just, looter in the place. Some new gloves. A shotgun. Useless, sell them gloves straight away. Got another grip. That shotgun yo, that shotgun has good damage. Look, 2024. Level 8, what am I now? I think I'm level 7, so we'll keep that in the inventory anyway. I don't really use the large machine guns due to the recoil. I don't even know if we pick new apparel. A ton of stuff. Alright, let's crack on with the next one. I think I picked up the weapon part that was there. I don't know why the icon doesn't just fucking disappear. Alright, so there's a crashed drone there, then another encounter. But yeah, that I picked out that weapon part, so I shouldn't stay on the map, cause it's confusing. Alright, there's a drone. Yeah, I remember these from the Alpha, as I had that. Because I've had this game pre-ordered since, I think, as soon as it was available to, after I saw the E3 demonstration. The first E3 demonstration. Happened during the quarantine of the city, I guess. Right, move on to this next encounter here. Was that another manhole?
Warning. Hostile presence detected.
Can't trust the cops in a situation like this.
You don't have to do this. Just let me go and no one has to die. Damn you!
It's quite hard to turn when you're aiming. The camera. There you go. Was just better off getting down the ladder. It takes another 2 seconds. Two identical cars. I like that, the glass effects, it's pretty cool. What did he drop over here? Need flashbang. Right, so we save this JTF. Got some consumables in these bags. Even if I've got full consumables, I'll still pick up the boxes or search the bags, as I can't help it. It's part of my compulsive looting that I have on games like this. You see me on Fallout. I can't help it. I've got to loot everything. Secured. So what special item are we going to get now? I think we've already got good ones already, I'm not sure. Let's have a look. Yeah, we've already got specialised ones. See, that's why you gotta loot. Loot and cranny, get them specialised blue weapons and items. Do all the little side missions before you do the main missions, because I'll tell you, once you get on to doing the actual mission, you'll be, you'll have all the weapons and armour to make it a bit easier for you.
What the hell are you doing? You're hurting him!
But yeah, let's do this mission. We're actually going to do the mission now. Stop that transmission I heard earlier. But to my knowledge, it wasn't very hard to do on the Alpha, but it was quite challenging, and especially the boss, as this is supposed to be played co-op, really. I mean, you can do it on single player. There's nothing stopping you playing it on your own, it's just some parts are a bit harder. But a few of my friends, fellow gamers, are planning on getting this. Well, they say they are. So that'd be good to jump in and out of co-op games with them for a laugh. I don't mind playing these games single player, I quite enjoy it, to be honest. You know, sometimes some people can be dead weight or be a bit slower than you and they hold you back. And but I hope to have good cooperative team players. Maybe I might join some random matches, who knows. So we've got a recording and a piece of fabric. Should be right there, right in front of me. Oh, it is. Was there another one somewhere? I think I picked it up, I'm pretty sure I did. It would be there otherwise on the map. I just want to know about that recording that came up. Let's try and have a look around this way. Oh shit. Fucking Lone Ranger there. Oh, here we go. No problem. Easy fucking pickings. As you can see on the minimap, it still says there's fabric in there, but I picked it up. It does that for weapon parts as well. It's weird. Once you looted it, it should, shouldn't appear on the map, because it sort of can confuse you sometimes. But it's not really much of a problem if you know you've been there already. Still haven't found a better mask. Let's see what other mods we got here. The only thing we've got can use on this submachine gun is the grip so far. The grips, scopes, suppressors on this bad boy. I think before we do this mission, it's literally opposite. It's opposite the mission itself, the base operation. So we'll pop back in here one more time just to sell unwanted items. See if we can get any more attachments or upgrades or better weapons. I think this seems to be at the minute anyway. It will be the last mission in the beta. I don't know whether we're gonna, once we beat it, that we'll unlock any more. But after doing all the missions on the beta, I plan to do another video series on the Dark Zone.
Check out the merchandise.
Which is a, can be a cooperative experience or a player versus player experience. Keep all the attachments. So now we finally broke $1,000.
Man, I love making deals. Nobody's got a better selection.
They still can't afford those. I think once you hit the dark zone, you get items that are worth a lot more money, because it's harder to get them. Good luck out there. But yeah, that's a nice rifle there. I do like that. It's got a lot more damage. With all those attachments on, I think that gun will be pretty good. But I think gun-wise, we've got some good stuff at the minute, so I might leave that. As much as I wanted to get it, I think I'll leave that.
Just window shopping, huh?
And have a look at the gear. Just in case we get some more protective items. I mean, that, I don't justify paying half the money just one more point. Especially for the masks, I mean. Capacity wise, it gives you one more space, but you know, it's
freezing my butt off. Good luck out there.
I can't really justify spending these amounts of money for these items. Let's have a look at the attachment and see what we got. You never know, I might end up buying that rifle after all.
I'm sure I've got everything you need.
Ain't seen nothing. Where does they used to use the Passaway Tunnel to stash bodies?
That's the thing, if I do get another rifle, it won't be suppressed. I don't think it matters, because if you find a group of enemies and you use it, they know what angle you're coming from anyway, but,
ain't seen nothing.
What should we do? Should we get it? How much is that one? So that one, if we just wait, I mean, double the price for not even 100 more, just over 100 more damage. I don't think it's worth it at this rate, so fuck it, let's do it, let's get it. Nice.
Hey, you want something else, you let me know.
Let's check this, compare this rifle. Look at the damage, like nearly doubled damage. It's got lower accuracy, reload speed, more stability, but I'm sure if we stick the mods on it from that gun, it could, should be pretty good. So let's we strip this weapon. Let's see how better this is if we mod this bad boy up. So it pretty is a sniper rifle, which is what I wanted. So we can't change the scope, but we can put the silencer on it. No grip mods either, so. So let's just equip it for now. We've always got the MP5 for a secondary, and you know that's a badass weapon. Right.
See what you've been missing.
Right, we're fully stocked, so we're fully ready to tackle this main mission now. We've done all the side missions, the encounters. I'm not sure if we've got all the collectibles that are on the map yet. I just know there's a few more locked doors on the map, but that's the thing, I don't think it bloody shows you where the locked doors are when you've been there. I'm pretty sure that survival guide's in a locked door area. But we'll come back for that after we do this mission, but we want to get the mission undergo first. Get some big bad action.
We've got a lot of hostiles inside, agents. They're holding Dr. Candle and her staff. We need those personnel back at the base so we can get the medical wing functional.
Yeah, I do remember there being a ton of enemies in here, and some of the sections are quite hard. I did die a few times on the Alpha, but you definitely want co-op partner or partners, if anything. Because there's multiple sections with multiple enemies. Where'd they go? So grenade-wise, we've got quite a few grenades. Oh, here comes the backup. Nice, we didn't even take one hit there. As you see on the minimap, there's still a red icon facing ahead of us, so... Oh, there we go, took our first hit. Let's try this boy out. Yeah, nice headshot, nice.
I might be able to find Candle's location.
Get a little rush during these firefights. Alright, let's have a little looky, see if there's any item boxes around. Yep. Hopefully get a grenade out of this box, or this bag. Oh no, it's just probably a snack of some sort. Yeah, we're full on consumables. I've had this MP5 quite a while now, it hasn't let me down. It's the thing about, like I keep saying about, doing all the side missions and encounters before you actually do the main missions, because you do get, come across and get good items that help a lot. And make things a little easier for you when you come across these big gangs. Alright, let's loot these bags before we go up to that set of cameras. Still can't pick it up.
Patched in. Let's see what I can find. Can you see the CCTV feed? Looks like Candle and her staff are being forced to treat their wounded. That's the only reason they're still alive.
If I remember rightly, there's a bag down here from the Alpha. Yeah, I was right. That's how much I played it. I remember the area they've given us to explore. I can't wait to see the final product and how big the map actually is.
Upstairs, in a restaurant.
But it should have so many hours of replayability. Yeah, that's right.
You should be able to pick them off without making yourself a target.
If I remember correctly, just as the computer AI just said, there's a lot of guys in there, and I'm telling you, I did die, and I have struggled on this part. But look at this stadium, man. It looks great. It's really great. This game, like, detail-wise, environment-wise, is really beautiful. The AI is quite clever as well. They do try and flank you. They do suppress you, and they do work together to eliminate you on this section. So even though I silently took him out, the enemies know where I am. Which is, makes the silence redundant, really. Because the whole point of it is for them not to know what angle or where their fellow teammates have been shot from. I don't know if the full version's going to have that or what, but it is quite frustrating. It does make the silencer pretty redundant.
Additional hostiles detected.
I do like the power of this gun, it is Nice. Yeah. Fuck this motherfucker up. You always want to take out that grenade guy first, because while these other hostiles are keeping you busy with gunfire, that grenade guy will fucking get that grenade off. Right, I think I just saw like a mini boss, like a leader by his blue bar, so he'll be quite powerful. Yeah, this guy here at the back. Well, I thought he would have been hard. But I am glad I picked up this rifle. This rifle is fucking excellent power-wise. Yeah, we seem to be doing good so far. Not really struggling at all. And like I'll say again, because of all the side missions and all the looting that I've been doing, I have got myself a good get-up of armour and items, weapons.
Word is that they've really trashed the place. It would have broken my dad's heart to see it go to hell like this. We used to watch games there together. I think it's better my folks didn't live to see any of this. But then I think about all the people doing their best to keep going. That's who we do this for, Agent. Go get them.
If I remember rightly, the next section full of enemies, yeah, just over there, is a VIP section / cafeteria bar.
To get to Kobe's, you'll have to pass by some contaminated areas. There used to be plenty of sick people being treated there before they got shot. So be careful.
Can we actually get into these contaminated areas or what? I can't remember. But I do know there's a boss battle on the roof. Yeah, here we go. Scientist of some sort there. Let's take this guy out first with the hostages. See what I mean? He knows where I am from using the silence weapon. It just doesn't make sense. That's one thing that I'm griping about on this beta. And if we do get another feedback questionnaire, like on the alpha, I will mention that.
Oh, they got him. On, take care of this.
Yeah, I'm pretty glad I made the decision to buy this rifle, because it's very powerful. Being able to pop these enemies with just one shot and take them out like that is fucking excellent, especially when you're playing single player on this. Now as we're closer, we'll switch to the submachine gun just in case any more enemies arrive. But yeah, I took all these out with ease with this rifle. Like I said, my only gripe is that, you know, I'm firing for a place, from a place that they don't know I'm at, with a silencer, yet when I kill a guy that's not in their viewpoint, with a silencer, they know where I am, and they just straight away go to return fire, and it's makes the silencer redundant. It really does. Oh, I thought that would have got him there.
The escort party's taking heavy fire from the roof. They can't move until you get up there and take down that gunner.
We're pinned down! There's no way we'll make it across alive unless someone can get up there and take out the big guns!
Well, that's what I plan to do, buddy.
All yours, Agent.
Make sure there's no other items about. Yeah, I'm actually really glad I bought that rifle. Really good weapon. Powerful. Just make sure there's no items hidden. Shitty consumables. Oh, we got a box. What we got here? Another bag. So we've just got a level 7 bag, which is 17. But I had a 24 one. Already got the specialized item. You know what I say on games like this, and I will say it again, loot. Loot and loot more. Loot and explore. Do all side missions before you do main missions. Do everything you can before you move the story on, because like I said, you know, you come to these missions, it's a lot easier as your character is more stronger.
We have an agent on the
has
roof.
Better equipment.
Made it to your position.
More powerful the weapons.
Just arrived. As soon as the hostiles on the roof are gone,
I mean,
we'll get her across safely.
This rifle's taking guys out in one hit with a silencer, so right, here we go. Rooftop battle coming up. Get behind some cover, really. There's another guy. Take out those small guys for the big dude. I have to use a health pack in a second.
Additional hostiles incoming.
There you go. Headshot takes away a shitload of health. I'll be honest, if that was the boss guy when I was playing on the alpha, I actually struggled a bit to take him out, but fuck me, this has been a breeze. Maybe more enemies are going to come charging out, fuck knows. Or maybe I'm just that damn good. What do we get here? Fucking nice. Right, should you check these ammo boxes, replenish? Might as well. I can't help it, I have to go to every box. Restock ammo, just restock everything. You never know. We don't need to go to that one over there, so let's just carry on now. Secure the roof. Pretty sure the roof's secured. Pretty sure I've secured the roof. What is going on here? I'm pretty sure this door here is supposed to open. And they're supposed to bungee down an elevator shaft. I don't know if I took the guys out too quick and it's glitched out on us or what. Let's just shoot the gun just to see if there's anyone hiding. I'll take that as a no. That was a boss guy and I took him out with ease.
Got the medic halfway across.
That was funny. Candle, suddenly it's finished now.
No casualties.
We're off to a good start, agents. Wish I could have had
you. There we go. It's open now.
I think we make a hell of a team anyway. When you get back to the base, we'll talk to Candle and we'll see what she can do for us.
Nice. That was some good shit. Enjoyed that. We need to get another shotty. I think we had a picked up a good shotgun down here. Look, 2,000 damage that one does. And this one does 2,008. Bloody hell. Nice. Got all the good shit. Still haven't got any better gloves. Still, because we got the specialised stuff. Still haven't got a better bag. What attachment did we get? We got is that another suppressor? Another grip or another scope? I don't know. We've got the 4%. Right, let's move on. Pretty happy with the way that went. Took them out with ease. Didn't really take too much damage. I guess just lost one bar. We can replenish that, no problem. Go replenish it, pick a new one straight back up. Med pack, that is. I think once we unlock this medical wing, that's the end of the missions and side missions and encounters, etc. I think you will. What's this? Find agents. Alright. completed, yeah. So you can do that over and over with other agents. But I don't know, I just sometimes prefer to do these sort of games on my own as a challenge to myself, being the lone wolf. But yeah, I think once we unlock the medical wing, that's it. The only thing we'll be able to do now is to replay that mission over and over, and then just find enemies that respawn in certain areas of the city. So I'll do another video series of the Dark Zone, the PvP mode that's on here. Right, let's sell off some weapons. Let's stash some weapons, actually, even though we won't be using them. I might as well just sell all these guns in here, because we're never going to be able to use this game file again. We will, I mean, look, got all these items here, you could probably sell all these guns. So let's take them out, fuck it, let's take them out to sell. Send the inventory.
This is an emergency services notification. Please report any suspicious behavior you see to the nearest JTF operative. Your confidentiality will be respected.
Let's choose what to keep, what to sell. So that's 2228. So we'll... Where was that 2.8 shotgun? There, so we'll stash that, because that's a good one. Right, we'll sell that, because that's shit. M4, so that's 300 damage. It's 301. So we'll keep the 301. Send that to the stash. 297, 34, yeah, we'll dash that off, we'll sell that. We'll keep this SCAR-H, just because it's a decent weapon. We'll keep the military M9, I have to remember that, military M9, keep that. And yeah, we'll just sell all these parts, these other parts we're not using, except the mods, always keep the mods. Right, so let's sell up, make some dough back.
Look it over.
Right, so we'll sell. There you go, just fuck all that shit off. Keep all the mods. We only got $800 as well from all that. We didn't even make enough to buy one of these special guns here. So you look at the difference. Oh no, that's the... It's a little bit better. It's got a talent on it, so it's got, you know, a special ability. But I think weapons-wise, we've got some great bloody weapons at the minute.
Man, I love making deals.
I think the only thing we can improve is the gear. But I'll only buy the gear that gives you a major difference.
I don't know what toys the LMB's got at their forward camp, but I want them.
Hey, get a load of this selection.
It's a 12 times scope. Just can't even afford them. Can't use that because we're not level 8 yet. Yeah, I guess we'll just buy that and
y'all come back again.
See what we can do with it. Can we use that on this? Yeah, we can. Nice. Right, here we go.
Well, look who it is. Thanks for getting me out of the garden. I've been in some hostile work environments before, but Jesus. Of course, it's not like this place is going to win any prizes either. Antique equipment, zero staff, patients lining up out the door. This isn't going to cut it.
We're doing the best we can, Dr. Candle. Any suggestions you might have, I'm happy to listen.
I know. Beggars, choosers, all that crap. What matters is beating this thing, but I can't do that without knowing more about it.
Here's a good place to start. Sarah is pretty sure Dr. Gordon Amherst had something to do with the outbreak.
God. That asshole. Saw him present a paper at Columbia once. He nearly started a riot. He's part of this. I need to talk to him. Anything of his you can find. Notebooks, laptops, close personal friends, I need that too. And we need to talk about live samples and antibodies. You're gonna be busy.
And you'll be?
Fixing this. Saving lives. Now if you'll excuse me, I'll get started.
Right, apparently we can upgrade this now.
The upgrades look great. If we live through this, I want you working in my lab.
New abilities now. Nice, we got to upgrade that. I don't think we got to on the alpha. So we get their pulse mod. So we've increased the range now. Damage is increased. Nice. Reveal all contaminated areas on the map. Okay. Maybe that's for the dark mode. I'm not sure if that'll work. Yeah, here we go. We still got more to do, so there's no more main story missions, but there's still some activities and secrets. Now will be I'll make a separate series doing the Dark Zone. So right, thanks for watching my playthrough of the Division Beta. That's the missions, side missions done. Pretty much what was there of story wise done. So yeah, come back to my channel and check it out to see the dark mode videos I will be making. Okay, nice one. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe please, and adios.